Namaste. My name is Leena Lal, VLCC Femina Miss India Kerala 2020. Well, I'm extremely new to the pageant world, so I'm like an empty vessel. I'm here to learn whatever I don't know and unlearn whatever I thought that a pageant world would be. Because only through living and experience one can know what the true essence is, right? But so far I have learned certain things and I'm trying to imbibe and inculcate in my life already. One of the things is that one needs to be always be prepared, whether it comes to grooming, whether it comes to your photo shoot or preparing for an interview, we need to be always be prepared. The other thing I know is that we need to be very aware about what is happening in the world, what is happening around us, like around with our people. And the third thing is there's no slacking. You know, whatever we give in, it needs to be 100%. Whatever effort we put in, it has to be 100%. So yeah, and also the fact that, you know, through my years of experience and my training in psychology, I have developed a certain skill set. Me being empathetic, compassionate, accepting, and patience. And I believe that one can get better each day, and I want to get better on such skill sets through this journey as well. I've learned certain great values so far, and I can't wait to see what this pageant journey is going to teach me furthermore. Ever since I knew I wanted to be something, I knew it was that I wanted to be a Miss India. And that came about because I was a huge fan of Aishwarya Rai. And my mom told me that she's Miss World. And I saw her wearing the crown, and that just like completely allured me. And I was like, I wanted to be this. I wanted to be that person of influence and be there. And of course, initially the whole glamour part of it really attracted me. But then as I grew up, I realized what the title means, what the significance it holds. And I was super passionate about it. It was my first ever career choice. I always wanted to do it. But as I grew, I realized that I did not match the height criteria. So I sort of took a backseat when it comes to getting into pageant or doing a pageant training. So for me, it was something I always wanted to do, but up until now, it was not in my cards. I did not believe it. But then with a stroke of luck, after 57 years, Miss India finally reduced the height criteria, and I can contest. And I was like, this is great. I was really happy to be a part of it. So that came as a surprise for me. So I really enjoyed that, you know, I'm like a part of Miss India, and here I am as a state finalist. This was my first ever try, and I got in, and I'm so glad, because next year I couldn't try for this. So I'm really glad that I'm living the first ever dream I ever had. Well, once I submitted my application, the first feeling I had was a sense of relief, because the last 1 month I put every ounce of my effort to make sure that my application is well-rounded and represents who I am as a person. This meant so much to me because it was a long-lost dream that I finally had the opportunity to work at it, like execute it. And I finally got this opportunity, and I did not want to make any mistake. So I was I was nervous, but once that feeling went, I was anticipating and I was excited, because if at all I get selected, I would be representing my state and furthermore representing my country, and that is something I always wanted to do. So once I got a call that I was the state winner, I was so confused. I did not understand that is this really happening, because everything happened so soon for me. Like, I wasn't prepared to even enter into a pageant, and when I got to know that the height criteria has been changed, I just grabbed this opportunity, and I was like, this is once in a lifetime opportunity. I have to take it. And I got it. I finally got it. So somewhere in my heart, I feel that it was meant to be. And I'm truly, truly happy to represent my state, Kerala. I want to make my grandparents really proud.